Hello, I'm Blake Ress, Commissioner of the Indiana High School Athletic Association. Today, I'd like to tell you about a friend to the more than 160,000 student-athletes in the state of Indiana, Farm Bureau Insurance. In their own low-key way, Farm Bureau Insurance has played a key role in the success of high school athletic programs throughout the state. Since joining the IHSAA as its exclusive corporate partner in 1988, Farm Bureau Insurance has contributed more than $3 million in support of high school student-athletes. On behalf of all the member schools of the IHSAA, we would like to take this opportunity to thank Farm Bureau Insurance for its support of our young people.
Has turned to afternoon. That means we're ready for our second state championship game of the day, the 2A state final game here at Conseco Fieldhouse. From the south, the Brownstown Central Braves. From the north, the Jimmies of Jimtown. Hi again, everybody. Chris Denary and Dave Nicholson getting you ready for the 2A state championship game. Waldron has won the Class A state final here this morning, 69-54. This is a matchup of two of the top four teams in the state. Brownstown Central is number one. Jimtown is number four. And it is a game of contrasting styles, Dave Nicholson.
You're exactly right there. Jimtown wants to go slow. They won a very deliberate game. Brownstown wants to push it up. Last week in the semi-state, five players in double figures for Brownstown. It should be interesting and may be decided by who can control the tempo.
All right, Brownstown and Jimtown coming up next, the 2A state final on the IHSAA Lacey Television Network. Central and the Jimtown Jimmies, the Class 2A state championship game. Brownstown is 27-1, ranked number one in the state. Jimtown is fourth in the state, 24-2. The Braves of Brownstown have won 24 straight games. Jimtown has won 20 straight games, so it should be a sensational ball game today. Game two of four today. This is the 2A state title game. And as always, Dave Nicholson will break things down. Let's take a look, first of all, at Brownstown.
Okay, Chris, let's take a look at the key players for Brownstown Central. Number 20, Clint Parker, a 5'11 senior. Clint averages 23 points per ball game. And in the middle, you're going to find number 44, Marty Young. He's a 6'3 senior, averages 14 points a game. Keys to the game for Brownstown this afternoon. They need to make their threes. They're going to shoot them. They need to go in for them. They have a balanced attack. Last week, they had five players in double figures in the semi-state and few turnovers.
This is a team that is second in the state in scoring average, and they're very, very good this year, making their first trip to the state finals since 1931. Let's take a look now, Dave, at Jimtown's key players.
Okay, for the Jimmies, you got to start looking at number 52 there on your screen, Carl Johnson, a 6'8 senior, 14 points a ball game. And number 44, Tyler Leighton, a 5'11 junior, averaging 16 points per game. Keys to the game for Jimtown, they must find offense. They have not scored as many points as Brownstown. Perimeter defense, they got to get out and defend those threes that Brownstown's going to throw at them, and they need to get the ball inside to the big guy.
Brownstown averages 74 points a game. Jimtown gives up just 39.6, and Jimtown head coach Randy DeShone has his players believing that defense wins championships.
Well, Ned Cook, our varsity assistant coach, is that's his primary responsibility. The kids always kid me that we work so much on defense and practice, that's all they know, and we do. We spend probably 50% of our practice time on defense, and it is a focus. If you want to play basketball at Jimtown, you've got to be able to guard somebody, you've got to be able to know our defensive philosophies, and it is a... a part of basketball that isn't fun for kids. It's just pure hard work. You know, all kids want to shoot past the basketball and get up and down the floor. Now we're going to say we're going to do something like taking medicine that's not very fun to do, and yet you got to do it every day and you got to do it hard. And they do a great job of working at it and trying to establish our style that we want to play.
Well, the lights are off here. That means we're getting ready for the announcement of our lineups here, our starting lineups, and the remainder of the teams here for Brownstown and Jimtown. Let's head across the way. His 19th year as the public address voice of the IHSAA Basketball State Championship. Here is Scott Gregg.
Number 14, Travis Maupin. Number 22, Jerry Hickman. Number 24, Jarrett Stahl. Number 30, Jordan Young. Number 40, Justin Pranger. Number 42, Mason Watson. And the starting lineup for the Braves of Brownstown Central, at guard, a 6-foot junior, number 12, Chandler Lambury. At guard, a 5-foot 11-inch senior, number 20, Clint Parker. At forward, a 6-foot 1-inch sophomore, number 32, Eric Parker. At forward, a 6-foot 4-inch sophomore, number 34, Pat McClintock. And the center, a 6-foot 3-inch senior, number 44, Marty Young. Head coach of the 27-1 Braves, Dave Benter. And now your roster and starting lineup for the Jimtown Jimmies. Number 14, Brian DeShone. Number 30, Jeremy Bloom. Number 32, Anthony Moore. Number 34, Tyler Nine. Number 42, Nick Tierney. Number 50, Nate Secor. Number 54, Jake Bowman. And the starting lineup for the Jimmies of Jimtown, at guard, number 20, a 6-foot 3-inch junior, Derrick DeShone. At guard, a 5-foot 10-inch senior, number 24, Corey Grove. At guard, a 5-foot 7-inch senior, number 22, Doug Polston. At forward, a 5-foot 11-inch junior, number 44, Tyler Layton. And the center, a 6-foot 8-inch senior, number 52, Kyle Johnson. Head coach of the 24-2 Jimmies, Randy DeShone.
There are your starting lineups. The 2A state title game, Brownstown Central and Jimtown, coming up next from Conseco Fieldhouse. Chris Denary and Dave Nicholson back at Conseco Fieldhouse. The 2A state title game, Brownstown Central and Jimtown. Some disappointing news for Jimtown. Here's Craig Wallen. Craig.
All right, Chris, thank you very much indeed. Very disappointing for Jimtown. Their point guard, Chris Trobaugh, who not only is a great point guard but can light it up from outside, he is sick with the flu, not likely to play. Back to you.
All right, so he averages 11 points and shoots 45% from three-point range. He is not in the starting lineup. In fact, I don't believe he's even on the bench. He has been sick. And so Brownstown has the ball. They're in the dark uniforms. They go right to the basket, and missing is Marty Young, who averages 14.5 points and 10 rebounds per game. And now the first opportunity to see Jimtown there in the white uniforms.
Both teams come out man-to-man defense.
That is Doug Polston. He averages less than a point a game. He's in the starting lineup now. Derrick DeShone, the coach's son. You'll see two coach's sons on the floor today, Brian and Derrick.
Jimtown running the flex offense, Chris. One of the most used offenses for years in basketball. Still very effective.
Now we have a pushing foul called against Brownstown Central. A little bit A little bit later, we'll hear from head coach David Venter of Brownstown Central, but we'll take a look at our starting lineups here in our Class 2A title game. Again, Clint Parker is an excellent player, a three-year starter. Marty Young is a three-year starter for Brownstown Central. They're both seniors.
And you got Chris Lamming in there, a two-year starter as well. So they're a veteran ball club over on Jimtown side. Fourth center guard, of course, 22.
He's pressed into the starting lineup. Corey Groh has the ball. Tyler Leighton, 15.8 points per game. He wears number 44 for Jimtown. Jimtown wants this game to be slow. Brownstown Central wants to up the pace. They average 75 points a game. Jimtown only gives up 40. And the Jimmies score, and that's Derrick DeShone.
I mentioned the fact that Jimtown's running that flex offense. I used to use that as a delay. So you can be really patient, always looking for your shot, but you can run that as a delay, and the other coach doesn't pick up on it, you hope, for a while. I think they're still running their offense.
Clint Parker missed, and the Jimmies have the ball. Kyle Johnson, will talk about him throughout the day. An excellent story. Here's a jumper in transition for three. It's missed by Parker, but Young the rebound. Nearly threw it away. It's saved by Pat McClintock. He is a nice-looking sophomore at 6'4". He had 27 points and 9 rebounds in their semi-state win over Centerville last week. And now Lambring walks. And it's a turnover against Brownstown Central.
I worked that ball game at Bedford last week, and McClintock went off big time for 27. He said he's only been in the lineup about 3 ball games. He was ineligible, did not play. It was a situation the first half where he could not play. But he's only been eligible the second semester and has started for 3 games, but he is a weapon.
Jimtown turns it over down along the end line. Tyler Leighton lost it. Kyle Johnson, the story on him, he averaged 10 points as a sophomore in a team that was 18-8 a year ago in the final football game of the season. His junior year, he tore his ACL. He missed some games this year because of that. He's missed 26 games the last 2 seasons. But Johnson, he wears 52 in the white uniform, is a big-time player for Jimtown, and at 6'8 is one of the reasons why they are playing here at Conseco Fieldhouse today.
You're exactly right, and I think Brownstown's well aware of that, because 3 times in possessions, Brownstown has forced the ball into Marty Young, and I think that's primarily to attack Johnson to try to get him a little foul trouble. Marty Johnson is only 6'3 in the middle for Brownstown, but he has that wide body, and he uses it extremely well.
Well, and Jimtown, I think, has one of those great names in the state of Indiana. You don't know them much for basketball. They have always been a very good football program up in northern Indiana. And that's Johnson, hits the free throw line jumper. And it's a 4-0 lead for the Jimmies of Jimtown.
Remember we said leading in, the key might be the team that sets the tempo. To this point, Jimtown is setting the tempo. Brownstown, I assure you, wants to go much faster and shoot much quicker. Jimtown has been able to use the first 3 minutes of this game to their benefit by several passes, being very patient.
Well, there you saw David Venter, and quickly Anthony Moore is in, a 5'10 junior, averaging a point a ball game. Craig Wallen knows this team quite well, says Moore's a very good defensive player. And again, they're without Chris Trobaugh, who is saddled with the flu, 11 points per game, a 45% three-point shooter. And Young is called for the walking violation. Dave, sometimes when you have a player of the caliber of Trobaugh out, it almost helps the team because they have to step things up.
Well, it could, but I tell you, it may not be the stats that's missing with Trobaugh, but you talked about the point guard. That's the heart and the engine
right.
That makes the team go, as you well know. And I think they played without him a little bit, but if you take the point guard off your team, it just takes a long time for all the pieces to mesh together, and that's got to have a tremendous effect today.
And Brownstown throws it away again. Now, the thing for Brownstown, I don't know when they got word that Trobaugh wouldn't be playing, but at some point, do you let your guard down a little bit?
Well, I tell you what, that's happened to every coach. They say, this star player is injured or sick, not going to play. Don't buy that. You got to prepare as if he's going to be out there and play the game of his life. And you just can't worry about someone not being there. You, as I say, expect him to play and be 100%.
Jimtown has a 4-0 lead. Brownstown has not scored. Near steal, but a personal foul. And it will be against Eric Parker, and we'll have our first timeout of the first quarter. 4 minutes in the books, and Jimtown has controlled the tempo. They have a 4-0 lead over Brownstown. This last 2A title game here at Conseco Fieldhouse.
Basil Mulby with us here, the head coach of Lewis Cass. And Basil, you were here last year in an undefeated season. We saw Waldron earlier today go undefeated and win the state championship. How hard is that?
Well, it's a very difficult task, and what a great job Waldron did today. And so I know how tough it was and what a great thrill it was, but certainly was a great game by Waldron this morning.
All right, Basil, good talking to you.
Hey, thank you.
Back to you, Chris.
Thank you very much. Dave Nicholson watching the Brownstown Braves off the tempo with some half-court trapping defense.
They came out in a 1-2-2 there, and it was effective, got the turnover, and they have to do something to speed up the tempo, so I think that's a good move by Coach Pender.
Well, Brian DeShone will come in, a coach's son, and so now the two sons in the backcourt, Brian and Derek. Randy in his 13th year. And his wife Tracy is 8.5 months pregnant and due any time. So it is an unbelievable weekend for Randy DeShone trying to win a state title. He and his wife Tracy expecting any moment. Here is a hoop and a score by McClintock for Brownstown Central.
Pretty good sophomore move right there.
So they're on the board, and now Jimtown has it in the half court. Derek DeShone averaging 10 points, 5 rebounds, and 8 assists on the year. He has the ball now for Jimtown. They've already used 9 players here in the first half. Moore catches, double team. Now the younger DeShone, they play pitch and catch. Again, they'll use a lot of clock.
Chris, a lot of people say, well, anybody can pass the ball, but as you see the big Johnson lay in the backdoor cut basket, but it takes a lot of skill to handle the ball, not turn it over, and to run the clock. You really have to be alert every second.
Eric Parker takes it in the lane and throws it away, but it's picked up by Marty Young. Clint Parker, an elbow jumper. It's around, no good. Rebound tipped out of bounds. It will stay with Brownstown Central. This year marks the 25th year for Bob Pointer GM Cars and Trucks, where they treat customers like you would like to be treated. At Bob Pointer's GM Cars and Trucks, they say, we'll really do sell for less and provide prompt, dependable service after the sale in Seymour, Indiana. Here's a drive down the lane. It's missed, but Young, the rebound, can't get it, and Johnson clears it for Jimtown.
Well, Brownstown dodged an easy opportunity there. Had two good chances.
DeShone has the ball now. Brownstown showing some zone. Johnson couldn't get it. Ball is stolen as McClintock made the steal.
Get it, Derek! Drive!
Marty Young is the all-time leading rebounder in the history of Brownstown Central. Personal foul called against Jimtown, and I believe it's on Anthony Moore.
You're right. It is on Anthony Moore. When you've been used to being a quick offensive team, like to run, get it up quickly, and the other team is running the clock as Jimtown is, it makes you put a lot of pressure on yourself if you're Brownstown. Every possession is so key.
Long three-point try is off the iron. Lambring missed it, and there's another foul. This one on Brian DeShone. That will be his first. Again, this is a, we saw two twin brothers in the Class A game. This game features a set of brothers on each team.
Well, you got Parker and Parker. You got Clint and Eric on the Brownstown team. And for Jimtown, of course, you have the Moores.
Or DeShones.
DeShones.
We'll have the Moores.
Moores are coming up next. Yeah. DeShones, the coach's son.
We've got all sorts of brother combinations here today. Ball is stolen. Turnover. Brownstown Central lost it. And Tyler Leighton had the ball stripped away. And the pace, Jimtown doesn't want to get up that quick.
No, but if you've got a chance to break the press, you'd probably go for it. The Parker boys on Brownstown, you're going to see a replay here before it. And they're... Jimtown's going quicker than what they want to with Leighton out on it, and almost got it intercepted there by Chandler Lambert and Brownstown. It'll stay with Jimtown. But the Parker boys on Brownstown, that's my home area many years ago. They had a grandfather, Paul Crockett. I'll tell you a Paul Crockett story. He's a stock car driver. He drove the small tracks in southern Indiana, one of the most competitive people I've ever met in my life. He's a barber in Brownstown, and I imagine a little bit of that competitive spirit is out here today in these two partners.
And Marty Young will be at the line. Again, the Brownstown Speedway. It is known when you talk to David Venter, a lot is known about the Brownstown area. You talk about racing, and Marty Young is on the board. Jackson County REMC congratulates Brownstown Central in their quest to win the 2A championship, taking pride in providing safe, clean, and reliable electric service to its members. Jackson County REMC, your Touchstone Cooperative.
Marty Young knocked both of those free throws in on that three. That's kind of unique because Marty's a 59% shooter on the year. He looked pretty good up there.
Brownstown has been number one in the state for much of the year. Nice pass inside. DeShone leaves it short, and Young lost the rebound. And a timeout is called as Brian DeShone picked up the loose ball. And a 30-second timeout is called by Jimtown. 30 seconds. Well, the head coach of Brownstown Central is an alum, David Venter. He was a star at Hanover College. He is the 14th all-time leading scorer at Brownstown. Earlier this week, he had a chance to tell us what the atmosphere is like in Brownstown prior to today's game.
We go back and after Saturday semi-state, and I think there's six fire trucks waiting on us at the school, and you know, hundreds of people, you know, for pep session. You know, we rode the fire trucks around town, and there were just people lined up in the streets. It's just an exciting time, and you know, the town's excited, the community's excited, and you know, it's just something our kids, you know, something they're going to remember.
Kyle Johnson scores for Jimtown. He has six of their eight. You saw David Venter, 25 points a game as a senior at Brownstown in 91-92, has the school scoring record of 47 points against Brown County, and was the three-time MVP at Hanover. He's a tremendous small college player. In fact, as the longtime voice of Butler, I saw David Venter and Hanover come in and almost upset Butler in the early 1990s. He was a tremendous college player. In fact, he was the Division III Player of the Year as a senior. And he is now doing it as a coach at his alma mater. Boy, some rugged play underneath. It is saved by Kyle Johnson and will remain with the Jimmies.
Well, I'll tell you what's happened. This half-court trap by the Brownstown Braves has got Jimtown hurrying. And that's what it's designed to do. You're going to see a replay here on the baseline of who was screened out. It looked like it did go right off the Brownstown players. Well, I guess what happened, Johnson stepped in there and batted it back in off the Brownstown foot. Nice hustle play by Johnson. But this half-court trap is making Jimtown go much quicker than they want to on the half-court.
Inbounds play is turned over, and Brownstown has the ball for the final 20 seconds of the first quarter. I don't think there's probably been too many quarters this year where Brownstown had 4 points in a quarter.
There's no question about it. When you're averaging 74 points a ball game, very unusual. They normally shoot a lot of threes. Give Jimtown's defense credit. They're getting out into them, giving them no room to see to shoot that three-point shot.
And the Braves throw it away. That is another turnover. They have five. Jimtown has six. So has not been a very well-played first quarter, and Brownstown is just one of nine from the field.
Coach Benner is talking about what a big celebration it was in Brownstown. They probably even closed down McDonald's and the Dairy Queen today. That's my home area. I can say that.
And the shot is no good. A long three by Kyle Johnson just ahead of the buzzer. And that's the first quarter. The Class 2A state title game. The Jimmies lead the Braves 8-4 here at Conseco Fieldhouse. Has a four-point lead after quarter number one, the 2A title game here at Conseco Fieldhouse. Your road to Conseco, Brownstown Central winning their own sectional, the Southridge Regional, and then won last week 81-73 in the Bedford semi-state. Up north, Jimtown advanced to Conseco Fieldhouse this way, winning the Westview sectional, beat Westview in the championship game, then won the North Judson Regional, and then beat Garrett last week by 12 to capture the Warsaw semi-state.
Key game there might have been beating that Hammond Knoll team. They had a great basketball team.
Shot is missed by Kyle Johnson. Very good player, and Gary Patterson, who will I'll tell you what, Butler has two pretty good players coming in. A.J. Graves, who had 40 last week for White River Valley in the Class A semi-state game against Waldron. And Gary Patterson is coming to Butler, played on a very good Knoll team.
The guard position should be in good hands for 4 years with those two guys coming in.
I look forward to talking about those guys.
My son's team at Lebanon, we played the Hammond Knoll team in the Hall of Fame Classic a year ago, and Patterson's a real deal.
Well, personal foul against Brownstown Central. Copper and Brass Sales in Elkhart is proud to be a part of the Valgo community and congratulate the Jimmies on making it to Conseco. A non-ferrous metal service company, Copper and Brass Sales, applaud the Jimmies on a fantastic season, helping to create great memories for all the Jimtown fans. Jimtown has controlled the tempo in this game. Dave, Brownstown Central coming in 20 games this year above 70 points. So that's 20 of their 28 games. They're sitting on four right now.
Well, Jimtown's just doing a nice job handling the ball, not turning it over. I thought that half-court press bothered Jimtown a little bit. But can you do that for 32 minutes and still be effective on the other end if you're Brownstown? It uses up a lot of your legs.
Now, the same time for David Benter and his ball club, they're only down 4 points.
No problem there. It's a four-point game, but definitely the tempo is favoring Jimtown.
Anthony Moore is back on the floor, a 5'10 junior for Jimtown. He will have to have more time today again. Chris Trobaugh averaging 11 points a game, a 53% field goal shooter, 45% from behind the arc, is out with the flu, so he is not available for Jimtown today. That's Derrick DeShone working. He was double-teamed. He gets the rebound. It's loose on the floor, and we have a walking violation against Jimtown.
I spoke of saving your legs. Let me speak of a man, young man from Brownstown, their student manager, Jameson Hyman. We got a replay coming up, and I'll finish that story. Good defense there by Clint Parker. Nice spin move. Comes down. Then he falls to the floor and scooted on the floor, and they call him for travel. He was bumped a little bit.
Jared Stahl is on the floor for the first time now for Brownstown, and two players just go careening into the bench across the way. Good hustle.
Let me finish that story on Jameson Hyman, student manager. He ran from Brownstown all the way to Conseco this week, 77.25 miles. Now, I know you do that regularly, Chris. My car wouldn't run 77 miles without some problem.
30-second timeout is taken by Brownstown Central. Hubbard Hill Estates Retirement Community invites you to check out their new West Wing located on County Road 24 off State Road 19, just north of the 20 bypass. Studio and one-bedroom apartments in the assisted living quarters are now available. Call them for details at 295-6260. That's 295-6260. Hubbard Hill Estates, we add life to living. And Lucas Ackerman, your hometown lumberyard and hardware, is happy to support the Brownstown Braves basketball team in this year's state finals. We at Lewis Ackerman are proud of Brownstown High School athletics. Jimtown inbounding the ball. Derrick DeShone gets it into Tyler Leighton.
Brownstown extended the man press full court. Might expect a little run and jump, particularly out of the Parker brothers. One of them will run and jump. Jimtown staying right in this flex offense, motion offense.
And a personal foul. And
that's got to be a technical foul right there on Clint Parker. He just two-hand shoved Derrick DeShone.
Well, it's been a very physical game, and Parker lost his head there and gave him a shove, and David Benter will quickly pull him out of the game. And part of that, I think, is the frustration right now for Brownstown.
Well, that's absolutely critical, because I think the personal foul's on Clint Parker. The technical count is the personal. That's two fouls, and he's the leading scorer on the Brownstown Central team. You just cannot get frustrated to that point.
So Kyle Johnson will shoot the technicals, and he leaves it short. And again, we keep talking about it. As distressed as the Brownstown Central bench looks, they are still only down 4 points. Johnson hits one of the two, and now Parker will leave, and Travis Maupin will come in, a 5'10 junior, and Parker will take a seat. And their leading scorer, 40 points from the all-time scoring leader in the career and the history of Brownstown Central. He's on the bench sitting next to his head coach.
And Jared Stahl's in the ballgame for Brownstown. Now, Jared Stahl, in all fairness, started up until McClintock became eligible in January, so he's got a lot of playing time on the court.
9-4, Jimtown has the lead. They have never trailed in this game. Jeremy Bloom, a 6'1 junior. Here's a drive in the lane. The shot is missed by Derrick DeShone. Kyle Johnson, the rebound, and tried to fire it off into the corner. Nobody there.
He was tangled up with his feet. He was going to travel, and he had to throw that ball. So I don't really blame Johnson for that mistake. He had to get rid of it or get a travel call. He was off balance.
9-4, the Jimmies have a 5-point lead. We have played 2 minutes here in quarter number two. Chandler Lambering almost walked Marty Young in the lane. Leans in and draws the foul. Kyle Johnson got him on the arm. And now Marty Young, who has two free throws to his credit here in this half, will shoot two more.
Young shows the ability to put the ball on the floor from the right baseline. Did a nice job spin move and had the defender back on his heels and drew the foul.
The People's Bank and its staff are proud sponsors of Brownstown Central Braves basketball. People's Bank, a community bank locally owned and operated. Go Braves from the People's Bank of Brownstown, Crothersville, and Seymour, member FDIC. There you see the foul. Second free throw is no good by Young. 9-5 score. Fans across the way from Brownstown not happy.
Well, this game's heating up a little. There's a lot of physical contact and just a little bit of extracurricular there with the arms and the elbows. So both crowds are very vocal, very active.
Inside out. And a big hoop by Corey Groh. A three-pointer from the right corner, and it's a 7-point Jimtown lead.
I might point out, Chris, the only game Brownstown Central has lost this entire year was to Seymour about the fifth game of the year. It was the lowest output of the year. They only put up 48 points in that game. As you see, Marty Young knocked down the 15-foot jumper.
And that is only the second field goal of the game for Brownstown Central. They are just 2 of 12. Kyle Johnson for three. And McClintock gets the rebound.
We might be seeing a parallel to that low output. Again, Brownstown just is not familiar with low numbers on the offensive end.
McClintock, his turnaround jumper on the baseline is no good. And Derrick DeShone, the rebound, looks to his father. Brings the ball up the floor. Jimtown has won 20 straight games. Brownstown Central has won 24 straight. And that time, Groh, who had just hit a three from the corner, wanted to shoot it again before he caught it.
Well, that was a no-look pass by Johnson. And Kyle, I don't know if he had to look away on that. He fired that thing like a bullet, and Groh just didn't gather it in.
Well, Jimtown already has 9 turnovers in the game. Brownstown Central has 5. And the Braves have it as we approach the halfway mark of the second quarter. And an offensive foul, illegal screen, is called against Brownstown Central. And the foul, I believe, is on Travis Maupin.
Well, Brownstown's been setting some tough screens, and I just happened to be looking at McClintock, and he just set a real tough screen at the top. Nothing wrong with tough screens. You've got to make sure you're stationary. And we're going to get Clint Parker back into the ball game. He has 2 personals, but he is the number one offensive threat for the Brownstown Braves, and Coach Pinter is going to bring him back in right now.
He had just 12 points last week in the semi-state win over Centerville, but they had 5 players in double figures. Lambering had 12. Clint's brother Eric had 12. Marty Young had 15. And we talked about McClintock. He had 27 points. So they did have balanced scoring, but Clint Parker has not scored. He is 0 of 5 from the field, so he has got to get on track for Brownstown Central. Chit Chat Cafe and Scrap Booking has a full stock of scrap booking and stamping supplies. 6 days a week they're open. They have on-site workstations, a play area for children, classes, and private parties. Located on Charlotte Avenue, north of the U.S. 20 bypass in Elkhart. Both free throws by Johnson. He has 9 points, and that equals the largest Jimtown lead of 7 at 14-7.
Well, Anthony Moore has the task of guarding Clint Parker, and he is on him like a glove. He's helping off in no way. He's staying nose-to-nose with him all over the floor.
And McClintock takes a bad shot down along the baseline, and Jimtown has it. 2-for-13, Brownstown Central. Team that shoots 51% on the year.
Well, you can kind of see why, because they select their shots carefully.
Jeremy Bloom, and then we have a personal foul. It's not what David Benner wanted.
Well, he felt Jeremy Bloom was had his elbows up a little high when he was ripping the ball through. Might have had a valid point.
And free throws now. Jeremy Bloom will shoot 1-1. He's only been there 10 times this year, but he's hit 7. Jimtown is a team at 74%. Had a nice conversation earlier in the week with Randy DeShone, the head coach. Again, you know Jimtown because of football. It was 27 years that they had not won a sectional game at some point, and 45 years without getting to a sectional final. They have won sectional championships in 2002, 2004, and both free throws are good by Bloom. And the largest lead of the half for Jimtown is 9, 16-7, the Jimmies here at Conseco Fieldhouse. Jimtown has used a 10-3 run to take a 9-point lead on the Methodist Sports Medicine Center scoreboard. Methodist Sports Medicine Center, a Clarion Health partner, providing sports medicine coverage for the Colts, 10 Indiana colleges, more than 25 Indiana high schools, and the official sports medicine provider of the IHSAA and today's state championship event. Call 1-800-SPORTS-MED. Sports Work Life, Methodist Sports Medicine Center, keeps you in the game. Brownstown Central trying to get a 3-pointer from Parker. Clint Parker misses, now 0 of 6 from the field, and Jimtown the ball with about 3 minutes to play, leading by 9.
Well, Chris, we've talked about the tempo of the game a lot, but let's give credit to Jimtown's defense. They're doing a great job. I'm telling you, Clint Parker can shoot the basketball. They're not giving him any looks.
Parker has the ball, throws it ahead, and he is fouled. And a holding foul is called on Anthony Moore. That's the second for Anthony Moore. 8 fouls, team fouls against Brownstown Central. That is only the 5th against Jimtown, so it will still be 2 more fouls before Brownstown will be in the bonus.
And Anthony Moore is going to get a rest with 2 fouls, and Poyston comes back in, and undoubtedly his job will be to really shade Clint Parker. And if you watch away from the ball, you folks at home that are watching, watch 22. He'll be chest-to-chest with number 20 in the black uniform. During this possession, he will not help off his man at all.
Jared Stahl out at the point, working against Brian DeShone, freshman, youngest of the two brothers for Jimtown. Marty Young in the paint misses, rebound tapped away, and Maupin got it for Brownstown Central. They continue to struggle from the field. McClintock on the baseline hit the side of the backboard. In
nice
transition,
pass.
And a hoop and a score by Tyler Leighton.
That was Derrick DeShone that threw that ball. Give him credit.
18-7, Jimtown has a double-figure lead for the first time here this afternoon.
Look at the bottom of your screen here and watch how number 20 and Black Clint Parker is being defended.
Clint Parker has it. Doug Polston defends. Parker, right wing to Stahl. Penetrates. Puts it up and in.
That's what has to happen if they're keying on one player. The other players on Brownstown Central must step up, and Stahl just did.
Derrick DeShone now to Leighton, looking inside. Kyle Johnson back to the basket. Leighton just scored. Pulls up again and hits.
Was that a great one-on-one move? He showed the shot fake, tucked one dribble to his left. Perfect balance, went up and busted about a 17-footer.
Both of these teams are two of the top teams in the state in scoring margin. Jimtown 7th. Brownstown is 1st. 8-2
run. About to get 5 second call.
Parker gives the ball to Maupin. Marty Young. Stahl just hit. Can he make it again? This time a 3.
I mentioned Jared Stahl had been a starter early in the year, so he's a veteran player.
He made 14 three-point field goals coming into this game, and now a foul is called. And should be It is against Brownstown Central. So at the free throw line will be Brian DeShone. As all the players were clearing back to the other side of the floor, I wasn't sure who the foul might be on.
Right, here's a replay on this tall three-pointer. Marty Young saw him open out on the left wing. He didn't hesitate. He flicked it into the basket for three. That foul was also on Jared Stahl. That's his second.
And Brian DeShone is at the free throw line. 6 foot freshman, 72% free throw shooter. Well, I'm sure no greater treat for those two, and I know you had the chance to coach your son. I had the chance to play for my father. It can be difficult at times, but also can be one of the most enjoyable things, and I'm sure in this instance for the DeShones to have two that are playing has to be special.
It is a special time, and you go through some difficulties and some trying times. People feel like you favor your son, and I wouldn't be surprised that your dad wasn't as tough or tougher on you than anybody on the floor, and as I was with my son Dan. But the pluses far outweigh the negatives when you've got a father-son relationship. And I still coach with my son currently as an assistant. That's a reversal of roles, but we still have that good working relationship, and I know you're very close to your father, Bob, as well.
Brownstown trying to get back in it, and then Parker gets hit across the face. There was a foul called, and then Parker went back up and got hit across the face again.
There was Derrick DeShone was the one defending. Nothing on purpose there, nothing intentional. Clint Parker was making a great hustle play and pulling the rebound, taking it back strong, and he tried to knock the ball down, and DeShone tries to come up and say, you know, I didn't hit you on purpose. And Clint accepts the five, and that's the way it should be.
And it will be free throw opportunities now for Parker. Earlier this week, had a chance to hear from Brownstown coach David Benner talking about a pair of gamers in the Parker brothers.
You know, they're really competitive, and you know there's good things and bad things about having brothers on a team, and you know those two, they just hate to lose, and you know I think they push each other. Clint's 2 years older, so Clint usually gets the upper hand a little bit, but Eric's been a really big addition to our team this year. You know, Clint's 40 points away from the score, both on the score, and you know, can do a lot of things, but Eric does a lot of different things. You know that they're similar in their competitiveness, but they're completely different in styles of play.
Well, Parker missed that free throw at 89%, but got his own rebound and scored, and now an over and back violation against Jimtown, and Brownstown Central has the ball with 33 3/10 seconds to play in the quarter.
That happened directly in front of us. I really thought Eric Parker deflected that ball. No complaint from the Jimtown bench.
Chandler Lambring working against Doug Polston.
That last basket by Clint Parker, that might be a real key. That's his first point of the game. I'm sure that's the longest in any game Clint Parker's ever gone without getting a point in the book. So he may cut loose.
Parker catches, guarded there by Derrick DeShone. Looks back door to Stahl, and Johnson blocked it, but a foul.
I don't know if Kyle Johnson, he probably is a pretty good shot blocker. He's in perfect position to take the charge here. Watch this backdoor cut on Stahl. And if Johnson had squared up, Stahl had committed, I feel certain he would have bowled over him. He chose to try to leave his feet. Not a good thing to do necessarily, to leave your feet and try to block a shot.
Jared Stahl now has 6, and his 6 points have been critical here in Brownstown's comeback.
He's been the one that's really given Brownstown a boost here in the second quarter. I mean, you do a lot of collegiate games, Chris, and collegiate ball, they've developed that shot blocking skill, but in high school, yeah. I really think about 3 out of 4 times you're going to get foul call when you swat at that basketball.
7 points for Jared Stahl. He has 7 of the last 9 for Brownstown Central. Full court pressure.
Jimtown would like to get out of here with the last shot of the half and maintain a little bit of this lead. I'm not sure that was a good shot.
Jared DeShone missed it. 5 seconds to play. They get the ball back. Save. 2 seconds. And the ball is stripped away. They call a foul. They call a foul. And if it is on the shot, it may be a 3-shot foul.
I think it should be. He puts up 2, but I thought it might be behind the line as well. And Coach Dave Benner, that was directly in front of him, and he really disagreed with that particular call.
Well, here's another look. I'll tell you what, he may have been behind the arc.
I thought he was behind the three, and I really thought he should be shooting three if indeed he got fouled. I also thought the defender got a lot of basketball.
Our officials today, Marvin Davis, Jerry Stiglitz, and Ron Grimes working the Class 2A state title game. 1 second to play. Brian DeShone now 2 of 3 at the line. Left it short. Lambring make that mopping the rebound, and we have our first half in the books here at Conseco Fieldhouse. Not the half that you would expect from Brownstown Central, averaging 74 points a game. They put just 16 points on the board here in the first half. And standing by with David Benter is Craig Wallen. Craig?
All right, thank you very much, Chris. Coach, 16 points here in the first half. You knew the Jimtown defense would be that tough, but were you surprised any at all?
No, we expected what they threw at us, but our guys were just way too impatient. And you know, we've just got to be more patient in the second half, and we turned the ball over and took bad shots, and we've got to get some things correct on the offensive end.
All right, Coach, thanks for your time.
Thanks.
All right, Chris, back to you.
All right, thanks so much, Craig. Well, Brownstown may not feel good, but they only trail by 6. It's Jimtown 22, and the Brownstown Central Braves 16 here at Conseco Fieldhouse in Indianapolis. Halftime at Conseco Fieldhouse, the 2A state championship game, and the Jimtown Jimmies have a 6-point lead. They have never trailed in this ball game. Brownstown has shot the ball very poorly in the first half, and both these teams come in with 20-plus game win streaks. Brownstown Central at 24 and Jimtown at 20. It's time for our Watson's trivia question. Who is the only coach to win a state championship in the one-class system and in the class system? We will have that answer for you coming. Only coach to win a state title in the one-class system and the class system. Right now there is only one. That's a Basil Mauby, Basil Ball. He won with Lewis Cass last year as a 2A champ in 2003. Connersville in 1983. Jack Kiefer could do it tonight. 22-16 at the half, Jimtown on the IHSAA LaCie television network.
With us, he played Jimmy Chitwood and Mars. So what an awesome opportunity here today to view something that you were a big part of in motion pictures, huh?
Yeah, I'd like to think so. But this such a fantastic experience. It's so much different being here for live games like this. The excitement is amazing. Indiana basketball.
Well, Hoosiers was a special moment, not only on the screen, but here in the state of Indiana, and we thank you for your part in it.
No, I appreciate it. I mean, I'd love to be a part of it, and it was a great experience.
All right, thank you very much.
Thanks.
Back to you guys.
Thanks, Craig, Chris Denary, and Dave Nicholson, as we're at the half, the 2A state title game, Jimtown 22-16 here at Conseco Fieldhouse.
Hey, Ryan, report started.
All right, we are back at Conseco Fieldhouse with Jimtown head coach Randy DeShone. Coach, real tight first half, low scoring, but that's kind of the way you want it, right?
Well, we're doing a great job defensively against them as a whole. We've missed a few offensive boards that have given up rebounds, and they've gotten the backdoor play on us a few times where we didn't get our help rotation. But to hold this team to 16 points, that's fantastic.
And you're doing it with some guys off the bench because of the illness to Trobaugh.
Well, he got up with the flu, and he's got to be horrible or he'd be here. So, yeah, we're having guys step up that maybe haven't had a lot of varsity time, and so far they're doing a nice job for us.
All right, Coach, best to you.
Thank you.
Thank you very much. Chris, Dave, back to you.
Thank you very much, Craig. As we get ready for the second half, let's take a look at some highlights. Dave Nicholson, my partner, longtime coach here in Indiana, will break things down. Dave?
Nice passing there. Ended up in Johnson's hand for the layup. Outstanding ball movement by the Jimmies, and there's a run out, which is rare for them. Leighton for the layup. Brownstown Stahl, who gave him a huge lift in that 7 points there in the second quarter.
You're right, he was big. Jared Stahl had 7. Clint Parker only has 2. He averages almost 23 points a game. Marty Young has 5. They had 16 points. They averaged 74 a game. You heard Randy DeShone. Did not think in any way. I think he wanted to control tempo, but I don't think he felt he could limit them to 16 points.
Well, and we need to emphasize again, they're playing without one of their best guards in Trobaugh, who is ill with the flu and averages 11 points a ball game. And so, when you're putting up 56, 11 is a major part of your offense.
That's a lot. So we're here to start the third quarter. Brownstown is in the dark uniforms, the black uniforms. They have the ball. shot it very poorly. 5 of 20 in the first half. McClintock can't score, but an offensive rebound by Eric Parker. Marty Young can't get it. Kyle Johnson blocks it away and gathers in the rebound.
Boy, Marty Young's had a tough afternoon to this point. He's had some good touches down low. Hasn't been able to score over the taller Kyle Johnson at 6'8".
Corey Grove, ball in the hands of Leighton.
There's that half-court trap by the Brownstown Braves again. That was effective, I thought, for the 3 or 4 minute period they used it in the first half.
And your Boyd's Baron Balloon headquarters, the Brownstown Greenhouse and Gifts. They say good luck, Brownstown Braves, in the state finals. And for 25 years, Walters Auto Sales and Rental in Elkhart has offered retail cars at wholesale prices. One block west of State Route 19 on Mishawaka Road, Walters also rents vehicles at great prices. In the heart of Jimtown since 1978, Walters Auto Sales and Rental congratulates the Jimmies on a fantastic year. Did they get it right?
I was screened out. Let's see if they did. They gave it to Brownstown. I didn't see it that way. We got to tell that third official. It's not to stand in front of us here, Chris. Having moved 12 feet either way.
Nearly a steal, and Anthony Moore was headed right at me. I was bailing out to my right.
I remember 2 years ago when I caught that Diet Pepsi.
I bailed to my
left. I found you behind the chair. You go better to your right than to your left. I remember that from your playing
days. That's right. No left hand. And that's my drives, too, go to the right somehow. Missed three-point shot. DeShone, 4-on-1. Derrick DeShone missed it. Ball batted out of bounds. Will stay with Jimtown.
And they had an opportunity to pass to brother, his younger brother, Brian, that time for a lay-in, but made a good effort and kept possession. We talk about the first 3 minutes of the second half. Neither team's established anything yet here in the third quarter.
Now Marty Young is whistled for the foul. This has been a very physical game. Both teams, again, Jimtown is known for, as a football school, a lot of these players play football. It's a physical game.
Well, I'm sure Coach Benner said we've got to be aggressive and physical because they are, but you've got to be careful not cross the line and get that extra shoulder into a guy and stay within the what the officials call the rules.
Leighton on the baseline. Now we have a 3 second violation. Kyle Johnson was in there. I think he was positioning himself for a rebound. He thought a shot would go up.
Well, probably should have gone up. The nice drive along the baseline got real deep, but decided to make that one extra pass, and you're right. Kyle got caught standing in there.
Brownstown Central, there's Young. Finishes for the Braves. So it's only a four-point game.
First points of this third quarter with almost 2 minutes gone.
Leighton in the lane, missed it. His own rebound. He'll throw it up and a foul.
He'll shoot two on that. They just stay after it. I'm really impressed with the Jimtown Jimmies' aggressive play. They just keep getting after it.
Tyler Leighton to the free throw line. Let's take a look at this again.
Now watch this. The ball gets free. Leighton just stays after it. They grab his arm, so he just says, okay, I'll throw up the basket and two free throws.
Tyler Leighton, 16 points a game. He is the leading scorer. Kyle Johnson on the year at 14 points. And Chris Trobaugh again is out with the flu, averaging 11 points. So Leighton now has six. And the lead is back to six for Jimtown. Brownstown crowd across the way. You see David Venter there standing up. That crowd is right behind him. The Jimtown crowd is behind us. Marty Young in the lane flips it in.
Well, you make the basket. It's amazing what kind of confidence that gives you. Marty Young came right back and stuck another one.
DeShone the other way. Nearly lost it. Brian DeShone.
Brownstown's picking up the defensive intensity.
Leighton at the free throw line. Calmly delivers the jumper. And again, it's amazing what two free throws also does for you.
Gives you confidence to step up and hit that field goal and maintain that six-point lead.
McClintock, his three is no good and a personal foul. Battling for the rebound, Marty Young and Kyle Johnson.
They got Young that time on the push-off.
Well, Young is outside there. He's at 6'3". He's a 200-pounder. And Kyle Johnson, you can see his value to this Jimtown basketball team. And why they were only 11-10 last year. They did not have him.
Here comes that full court press now by Brownstown. They're going to keep the pressure on as well they should.
Now they have four
on
two.
Nice bounce pass.
DeShone got it to Leighton. He's up for the shot. Six straight points for Tyler Leighton. It's an eight-point Jimtown lead.
DeShone just threaded that needle, and that ball never got more than 2 feet off the ground on that low bounce pass. A pass that players, in my opinion, should use a lot more of, particularly when you're passing through the basket in the low post area.
Anthony Moore all over Clint Parker.
Well, he fouled Parker. I thought that time he got him a couple blows, and they let it go. No knockdown, no call.
And Jimtown now with an eight-point lead. Brownstown has extended this defense.
Here's that 1-2-2 half-court trap by Brownstown.
Kyle Johnson. Clint Parker the rebound. Again, Parker has just 2 points. Went almost 14 minutes in the first half without scoring. Now gets there and turns it over. Derrick DeShone spins to the basket. Missed it. Marty Young has the rebound for the Brownstown Central Braves. They trail by eight. A basket and a foul. Chandler Lambring with his first field goal of the game has a chance for a three-point play.
Nice card take there. You're going to see the replay at home. Here comes Chandler Lambring. He just keeps pushing it with a left-handed dribble. Splits the defender, goes in. Had to change his shot in midair and also drew the foul.
And Derrick DeShone is called for the foul. Picks up his first.
You know, I talked about Brownstown Central being what would be my, considered my home high school. Consolidation of Freetown, Cool Springs, all these big names you know about, Tampico. And the big key is Bologna, of course. That's probably what made their sports program.
Halfway through quarter number three. Lead was six at the half. That's where it is right now. And a near turnover, but Jimtown will have the basketball. 3:55 to play, third quarter. Jimmies lead by six on the Methodist Sports Medicine scoreboard.
We are back at Conseco Fieldhouse. We talked earlier about Jason Hyman, the student manager from Brownstown who ran to Conseco. Well, you're looking at Francisco Bale. He's the student manager for Jimtown, a foreign exchange student from Spain who played soccer and swam, tried out for the basketball team, didn't make it, but wanted to be a part of the program. Back to you guys.
Thanks, Craig, and Jimtown has it, and Derrick DeShone hits a jumper. 4 points now for the oldest of the two coaches' sons on the floor. It's an eight-point Jimtown lead. Marty Young tries to pick it up, may have dribbled it out of bounds, but Jimtown knocked it away.
I'll tell you what, Jimtown is not only aggressive with their feet on defense, their hands are so active. They've had a lot of deflections today.
McClintock to Stahl. Young spins to the basket and puts it in. It's been a good quarter for Marty Young. Three field goals. He now has 11 points in the game.
He's got a really quick one or two dribble move for a post play. Good spin move.
15 points last week against Centerville. Leighton. And Young has the rebound. Brownstown Central with 3 minutes to play and counting. Trailing by six. Lambring. We have a foul. And it's a blocking foul called against Brian DeShone. That means free throws for Chandler Lambring. Woodland Manor in its city. Let's take a look at the replay.
You just saw it, and I'm not sure that DeShone moved, but there it goes again. Nice left-handed dribble by Lambring. Looked to me like he was set, Chris. I hate to say that, but I thought the defender was there.
30-second timeout called by Jimtown. Woodland Manor and its senior citizens are proud of the Jimmies for their first trip to the basketball state finals. Proud to be serving the community by providing private Medicare suites and a one-of-a-kind secured Alzheimer's units. Woodland Manor, recently been remodeled, located next door to the Elkhart Clinic. Woodland Manor residents want to wish the Jimmies good luck. And Wakarusa Medical Clinic knows the importance of a solid education and is a proud sponsor of high school sports, reminding students to challenge themselves with academics as well as athletics. Wakarusa Medical Clinic thanks the community for your continued patronage. And again, Jimtown located up in the northern portion of the state. Elkhart and South Bend area right there in the pocket there. And many fans from the north have come, just as they have come from the south down around Dave's hometown, Brownstown Central. And there you see David Venter, his sixth year, 82-59. His first year, he won just four times, and he is coaching his alma mater. Both free throws are good by Lambering, and it's a four-point game. Walking violation called against Jimtown.
Yep, that was Anthony Moore, just didn't get rid of the ball before he screwed his feet. There's always got to be a player step up when you're fighting back. And this quarter, it's clearly been Marty Young of the Braves. He's 3 of 6 shooting, 6 points and 2 rebounds here in the third quarter.
Lambering to stall. Man-to-man defense by Jimtown. McClintock looks for Clint Parker. Parker works against Anthony Moore. Free throw line and draws the foul. Free throws now for Clint Parker as Moore has picked up a foul, and that's his third. And for Brownstown Central, they could get within two here on free throws by Clint Parker. The last time it was a two-point game was 6-4 back in the first quarter.
And I like what Coach Benner has done with his ball club after that last time out there attacking the basket with the dribble. First, Young went off the dribble out of the post area. Parker that time and Lambert. All three have made good penetration dribble. Putting a lot of pressure on the Jimtown defense.
Second free throw miss for Parker, who comes in at 89%. And he missed them both. He missed both short. Kyle Johnson the rebound. It's on the floor. Jump ball possession arrow belongs to Jimtown. So it's been that type of afternoon for Clint Parker. 89% free throw shooter. He's missed three here today.
Well, he averages almost 23 points a game, and he's only had one field goal. So tough afternoon. But, Chris, you and I know that when the game's on the line, a player of his caliber is likely to be the one to step up in the last 3 minutes and get it done for the Braves.
2:35 to play. There you see the score on your screen. Jimtown, if you're just tuning in the white uniforms, Brownstown in the black. This is the 2A state title game. Waldron won the Class A title game earlier this morning. They beat Fort Wayne Blackhawk Christian. Full court pressure by Brownstown. And DeShone deposits the ball to Polston, and now they're in the half court.
Nothing flashy about Jimtown, but they're very solid with the basketball. Good fundamental dribblers that come to a jump stop, and I say that and we turn it over, but there was a little contact there on DeShone.
Parker penetrates, tries to dump it in on the bounce to Young. He scores and a foul. Marty Young has 8 of his 13 here in the third quarter. It's a two-point game now.
And the young man primarily responsible there at the free throw line. You're going to see a great pass from Clint Parker down, bounce pass into Marty Young. He fights for the loose ball, gets it up and in the basket, and gets a chance for a three-point play.
30-29. Brownstown now as close as they have been. They have never trailed by one in this game. They have never led. Jimtown scored the first 4 points of the game. And now the momentum clearly in Brownstown's favor, but a personal foul called against Jared Stahl.
Holding on the inbounds play. And both teams are really putting bodies on people defensively. It just depends on how the official sees that. But they're really watched as a lineup here. They've got four people in the backcourt. Brownstown will be belly to belly with them.
Jeremy Bloom saw action in the first half. He's on the floor for Jimtown. He has the ball now. They still have not gotten over the 10-second line. Now they do.
Nine and a half.
Leighton. Yeah, that was
nine
close.
And a half count.
Derrick DeShone to Johnson
Brownstown
in the corner.
Brownstown's trapping everything.
And a big hoop there by Kyle Johnson. He's in double figures with 11. It's a three-point Jimmy lead.
That was almost out of desperation. Kyle Johnson had no one to pass to, so he's out there shooting.
McClintock misses. Johnson the rebound. Bodies were flying underneath the basket. And now there's a loose ball and a scrum at the center court. And a jump ball. Very, very physical game. And at what point, if you're an official, do you draw the line?
Well, I think they need to get a little bit of control here. But I hate to see officials completely change. Be consistent. If they're going to let him play. Now, that's a good scramble for the basketball.
And that's what this group has done today.
Right.
Been very
if they
consistent.
Let it go, I hate to see him come up in fourth quarter and start calling everything. That's not fair to the players or the coaches in knowing what to expect.
Brownstown continuing to shoot poorly. Here's a long three. It's missed. And the rebound.
Clint Parker came flying all the way across the court. I'm talking about 50 feet away. And outstanding hustle. He didn't get the ball for his team, but you really have to respect the hustle that he just showed.
1:13 to play here in the third quarter. Conseco Fieldhouse in Indianapolis, the site of a busy day of high school basketball. Closing the season on the 2003-2004 season. Two more games tonight, Class 3A. Belmont and Evansville Modern Day, and then Columbia City and Lawrence North.
Nope.
Ball is well short by Tyler Layton. Marty Young the rebound. Less than a minute to play. Here's a long three by Parker, no good. And then we have a foul. And it's over the top, McClintock.
You know, I think that was probably a foul, but of all the things, as you hear the Brownstown Central crowd, of all the things you don't call that they have let go, then they call that, and that's what I was calling about maybe confusing a player a little bit. And I don't mean to be too hard on the officials. They got a heck of a job on their hands in this ballgame.
Doug Polskin on the floor playing with Corey Groh. Tyler Layton, backdoor pass. Kyle Johnson catches. His wraparound layup is no good. 30 seconds to play.
Johnson made a more difficult shot out of that than he should have. He had the open shot on this side, and he decided to go under and roll it back.
Lambring out near the center circle. Brownstown Central down by three. Works for the quarter's final shot. Lambring. Contact and a foul. Derrick DeShone, and free throws for the Braves.
Well, the difference in the possession since Dave Benner took his timeout about 3 minutes ago, he obviously has instructed his team to attack the basket with the dribble. And here comes the Lambring right down the middle, leans in, draws a contact. Nice job of taking it.
10 seconds to play, and the free throw is good. The State Bank of Medora, proud sponsor and proud of the Brownstown Braves basketball team, wishing them continued success. Stop by or call the friendly folks at the State Bank of Medora, a small bank with a desire to grow. Member FDIC, East Main Street in Medora. Both free throws by Lambring good. It's a one-point game. 10 seconds to play in the third quarter. Layton to the basket. Missed it. Rebound McClintock. 4 seconds. Lost the ball. Young.
No.
And it won't count. And that's the way the quarter will end. Brownstown Central has made it a game here in the fourth. Jimmies by one on the Methodist Sports Medicine Center scoreboard. Jimtown has never trailed as we head to the fourth quarter. They have a one-point lead over Brownstown Central, 32-31. Kristen Airy, Dave Nicholson, Craig Wallen, our entire broadcast team on this state final Saturday, bringing you the 94th IHSAA State Basketball Championship. This is the 2A title game, and Jimtown in the white has the ball. Ball is kicked. Chit Chat Cafe is open for breakfast and lunch Monday through Saturday in Elkhart. They feature fresh breads, pastries, sandwiches, and soups. Also, by patronizing them, you'll help people right in your own community as part of their proceeds help local nonprofit organizations. Chit Chat Cafe, located on Charlotte Avenue, north of the US 20 bypass in Elkhart.
Brownstown staying right with that 1-3-1 trap on the half court.
And Kyle Johnson with a big three-point field goal, 35-31. Has he stepped up today?
Right, look at 6 people that they had listed, their best 3 shooters. Johnson's not on that list, but he's good this afternoon.
That's only his 5th of the year. 33% coming in. Marty Young turns against Johnson, and Johnson fouls him. And Marty Young back to the free throw line. He had 9 of his 14 points in the third quarter and really brought Brownstown back into this game.
Here's a replay, and Marty Young has been doing this all day, but he didn't start finishing these shots until the third quarter. His confidence is sky high. Look for him to continue that. If he can get Kyle Johnson's 4th foul in the next minute or two, that would be huge.
50 years of excellent customer service, still the backbone of what buying a new vehicle from Hamilton Motors on Highway 50 in Brownstown is built on. Come see John, Andy, or Lisa. See why buying a vehicle from Hamilton Motors is not only easy, but affordable. Tyler Leighton picking up the loose ball in the corner. It is a two-point Jimtown lead, and the steal by Parker, Clint Parker, with a right hand lays it in, and they tied the ball game for the first time.
I was watching Clint Parker on that. He laid on that passing lane. He was just waiting for it, timed it perfectly. Remember what we said, when the game's on the line, expect Clint Parker to be a major player for Brownstown.
And Randy DeShone wants a timeout, trying to stem the tide of Brownstown's 13-5 run. It is a full timeout here in the fourth quarter in Indianapolis. We're all tied, the 2A state title game, the Jimmies and the Braves on the Lassie IHSAA television network. There you have a look at the Methodist Sports Medicine Center scoreboard. Brownstown Central and Jimtown tied at 35. 6:46 to play in the fourth and final quarter. And Jimtown has the ball. They're in the white. Kyle Johnson. Back-to-back threes now for the Jimmies.
Well, Johnson comes in, obviously, as their, by far their leading scorer. When the game gets down to win time, you go to your players that have played well all year.
And McClintock, he had just one field goal in the first half coming in. He ties it with a three. And then two players just collide right in front of us to our left. That was McClintock. And a player for Jimtown, that's Derrick DeShone, going under one of the media.
Here's
ropes.
A replay on this. This is a great collision. I mean, a hard collision right there.
Oh, my.
And I believe that would stay with Jimtown because McClintock was on the sideline for number one. And I'm not sure.
Did they call a foul?
I don't know. I missed that. That happened directly in front of us, and I could not see.
That looked like Derrick DeShone was the running back, and he lowered his shoulder, and McClintock made the tackle. Lewis Ackerman, your hometown lumberyard and hardware, happy to support the Brownstown Braves. Lewis Ackerman, proud of Brownstown High School Athletics. Pass is nearly thrown away. Jimtown with it, DeShone, and his ball for the walking violation.
Got tangled up and drove his feet there.
So Lucas Ackerman, a proud sponsor of Brownstown Central, happy to be a part. You look across the way, Dave, that many people in that area, they've taken up almost one half of the building here today.
Steve Ackerman and Dave Lucas started that, took over, actually, I think, for their dads, running that lumber yard, and they've been doing it for several years, do a wonderful job.
Parker misses in the lane, rebound tipped away. Derrick DeShone has it, tied at 38. DeShone working against Clint Parker. Holston in the right corner. Leighton comes out of there. Brownstown Central in a 1-3-1, it looks like. Kyle Johnson fouled. Eric Parker got him, and Kyle Johnson has answered big time today. 13.7 points per game, 7 rebounds. He has 17 points here today.
Here's a replay on that. You see Johnson turns, and Eric Parker just comes over, contests it, gets his arm. Talk about putting the team on your back. You have to think that Kyle Johnson has decided to do that. That's his 7th point here in the fourth quarter already.
He has 19 points now and 9 rebounds. And it's a 2-point lead for Jimtown at 40-38. They have never trailed in the game. Eric Parker looks cross court for his brother Clint. McClintock, Marty Young. Double team there by Brian DeShone and Kyle Johnson. Now a long three, and Brownstown has its first lead. That's Chandler Lambring from downtown. 41-40, the Brownstown Central Braves with the lead.
Well, you're down to a situation now with 4 minutes, under 5 minutes to go, 4:55 to go. every possession is so important, you have to wonder which team has been in this situation the most. Probably been Jimtown with their low score, close games, whereas Brownstown Central normally has a comfortable margin. So it's going to be interesting to see the response from here on out.
Well, you make that point, Dave. Only seven games this year Brownstown has played where games have been decided by 9 points or less. So they've really not been in this position many times.
No, so you have to think maybe Jimtown's more used to that. I just point that out because it's going to be interesting the next 4:49 to see which team takes advantage of each possession.
There you saw the numbers on Derrick DeShone already with six assists. He averages 8 per game. Talking about Jimtown and head coach Randy DeShone, he has this to say about coaching his two sons.
We've grown up with basketball. When Derrick and Brian were little, we'd drive to scout games. And, they're 3, 4, 5, 6. And on the way home, we talk about the game. What do you think? Who's their best player? And what would you do to stop him? It's a thing that we've built a relationship on. I have a daughter that's a sixth grader that plays basketball. Now we're doing the same thing with her, a little six-year-old that's starting to play, and we talk about it. And especially with my daughter, it's a great way for a dad to have a bonding experience with his children. It's easy with boys because there's usually a lot in common, but it's just been an awesome experience for us.
Randy DeShone, his 13th year, 144 and 142. There you see the replay, the action you were watching during that interview, a blocked three-point shot, and then Brownstown Central got the rebound and was able to get a 30-second timeout. I think Jimtown thought that they had a fast break opportunity, but Chandler Lambring was able to make a difference.
Right, Derrick DeShone deflected it. And on the very next play, when Jimtown tried to pass, Chandler Lambring deflected it, and Brownstown came up with the timeout. Advantage Brownstown with the score tied. Every possession, I keep saying, but that's so important right now. It's something.
Located in Jackson County, Brownstown Central, representing the southern portion of the state here in this Class 2A final. They're ranked number one, 27-1, a member of the Mid-Southern Conference. Marty Young on the baseline. McClintock made a three here in this quarter. Tie score. Lambring to the basket, throws up a shot. How does it go in?
He was determined to get it up there. Actually started, thought he might have taken an extra step, but he got it down.
He has an 11-point second half after going scoreless in the first half. And Tyler Leighton answers for Jimtown. Leighton has 12 points. He has 8 of those here in the second half. Inside 4 minutes to play. Ball is stolen. Brian DeShone comes up with a loose ball. Bounces now to Kyle Johnson. And Jimtown will attack.
Another great defensive play by the Jimmies there. They were able to strip that ball from Lambring.
And a shot in the lane. Anthony Moore, his first field goal attempt, and he scores. And Jimtown back in front by 2.
Brownstown on that half-court trap. The backside guy is not dropping down, and Jimtown has had success twice now throwing over the top.
We've had 4 ties here in the fourth quarter. Now make it a 5th tie and a chance for Brownstown to regain the lead on a nice move by Marty Young. Marty Young has had a solid second half for Brownstown. He had a 9-point third quarter. He has 4 points here in the fourth, trying to make it 5 and trying to get Brownstown Central the lead again.
I'm impressed with how he knows how to position down low and his footwork.
Misses the free throw, and Derrick DeShone the rebound. 9th rebound for Derrick DeShone. He has 5 points, 7 assists, and 9 rebounds.
There it is again over the top.
Great pass to Kyle Johnson.
The wings are not dropping on that 1-3-1 trap at Brownstown. The opposite wing's got to drop down and cover the opposite block. That diagonal pass is killing them right now.
21 points for Johnson. The lead is 2 for Jimtown. They get the ball to Young, right to the basket, left it short. Kyle Johnson has the rebound. He has a double-double. His 10th rebound along with 21 points.
Well, Young wanted that ball badly because he had a mismatch with Leighton, only 5'11", guarding him. They got the ball there, but he wasn't able to finish it.
Personal foul against Brownstown Central. Well, you think some guys will sleep well tonight?
Oh, this has been a bruiser.
The People's Bank and its staff are proud sponsors of Brownstown Central basketball. People's Bank, a community bank locally owned and operated. From the People's Bank of Brownstown, Crothersville, and Seymour, member FDIC, they say, go Braves, as Derrick DeShone hits the free throw.
Here's a replay on that. Derrick DeShone's battling for his life, and McClintock comes up behind. He's kind of off balance and bumps him and admits, I fouled him. And Derrick DeShone hit one of the two.
Three-point lead for Jimtown, approaching 2 minutes to play. Fourth quarter here at Conseco Fieldhouse in Indianapolis. Clint Parker wrapped up by Anthony Moore. McClintock in the lane against Kyle Johnson. Doesn't get the roll. Johnson tried to get the rebound.
Everything went in for McClintock on that one.
But he was aggressive and got the rebound.
He traveled again. Now, I'm telling you, that's twice. Chandler Lambert's making aggressive move, but he travels on that move. He got the call that time, and we'll shoot two.
Well, fortunately, we're just over here as broadcasters, and Lambert will go to the free throw line to shoot it twice.
Now watch his feet. What do you think? I'm not saying anymore. I'll let the people decide that.
Lambert hits a big free throw. 10.3 points per game on the year. 4.5 rebounds and 4 assists per game. He's had a very nice second half with all 12 of his points and now narrows the gap to 1. 48-47 Jimtown. Leighton is fouled. Lambring is guilty. And free throws now for Jimtown. For 25 years, Walters Auto Sales and Rental in Elkhart offering retail cars at wholesale prices. As we watch the foul on the replay, they're very proud of their Jimtown Jimmies in the heart of Jimtown since 1978. Walters Auto Sales and Rental congratulates the Jimmies on a fantastic year. They're located one block west of State Road 19 on Mishawaka Road. Free throw good by Leighton, makes them both. 10 and a half, 14 in the game for Leighton, and Jimtown by 3, 50-47.
Two good ball clubs, Chris. Both of them are scoring on almost every possession.
Parker misses. Rebound, his brother, Eric Parker, and he'll shoot free throws now for Brownstown Central.
I believe that's going to be on Brian DeShone, which is his fourth. His fifth? I did not have him for 5, but they do, so he's gone for the afternoon. Great effort there by the freshman.
So Brian DeShone, he was really brought to the varsity this year because you talk about Jimtown, they had all sorts of injuries. The only player that didn't miss a game this year due to injury was junior Derrick DeShone, and he missed games last year because of a broken ankle. So this team has fought through injuries all year long.
You got to think Randy DeShone is really proud because, remember, Jimtown is playing without their starting guard, Chris Trobaugh, the 5'9 junior. He averaged 11 points a game coming into today's game. He's sick with the flu, as we mentioned earlier, not even here playing.
Eric Parker missed, and now a foul. Clint Parker is guilty of the foul. And Tyler Leighton will walk the other way and shoot free throws. Jimtown has been the better free throw shooting team here today. 15 of 19 at the line at 79%. Brownstown Central at just 64% at 14 of 22.
There you saw Leighton just start to take it on the dribble, and Clint Parker was not able to move his leg out of the way, and he caught him with the knee.
Talking to Randy DeShone earlier in the week, this is a program that has only, in the history of Jimtown basketball, won only 40% of their games. They have a 5-point lead and are 90 seconds away from a state title.
He's going to basket.
Clint Parker, long three, short. Kyle Johnson, the rebound. Derrick DeShone, fouled by McClintock. And now it could turn into a free throw shooting match here for Jimtown.
Well, and Jimtown's had a lot of confidence up there recently. They have made a lot more free throws today than has Brownstown. Not only have they shot a better percentage, but they've made a lot more. So Brownstown Central, I'm sure, knows who they would like to get at the free throw line, but you can't always pick that out. With only a minute 19 to go, you got to stop the clock.
And Pat McClintock is fouled out with just 5 points. And he is out of the ballgame for David Venter. He'll go to the bench, and Jared Stahl will come in, who had 7 first half points. Woodland Manor and its senior citizens are proud of the Jimmies for their first trip to the basketball state finals. Woodland Manor proud to be serving the community by providing private Medicare suites and a one-of-a-kind secured Alzheimer's unit to the families of Valgo. Woodland Manor has recently been remodeled, located next door to the Elkhart Clinic. Woodland Manor wishes the Jimmies good luck. DeShone, the free throw.
We had Jared Stahl come back in the game for Brownstown to replace McClintock, who just fouled out. Remember, Stahl got 7 points in the second quarter, so he might be able to knock down a pass for them.
7-point lead. The shot is blocked, and Polston gets the rebound, and we have a personal foul.
It's on Marty Young. He was just trying desperately to get that rebound and committed to personal.
Well, wait a minute.
They called it the other way.
Yeah, Marty Young was on the free throw line.
Nice break there for the Braves. They've got a chance to cut into this 7-point lead.
Well, wait a minute. Somebody's got to look at the clock. The clock is counting down. I'll tell you what.
It's still running.
The clock is still running. They have got to go back and put some time up on the clock.
Now, there's approximately a minute, 6 or 7 seconds that should be on the clock, in my opinion, Chris.
Yeah, I think maybe more. I maybe think 108 or 109.
Okay. That's the right area, because we're not showing the clock there, but here's where the scramble is for the ball. Boy, how they got that foul against Jimtown on that one. Am I seeing the same thing here?
I think 1:12 to play, and that's, again, the stat crew has the timing on the clock. So 1:12 to play, 7-point lead for Jimtown. Randy DeShone there talking to one of the officials. I think he maybe liked what he heard. He'll walk back to the bench.
Well, he'd like to have kept that down under a minute. But
I think he liked it down at 56
seconds.
I think
he had to accept what he heard.
One and one opportunity for Marty Young. And he gets the free throw. 6-point game.
Not what you want to do if you're Jimtown. Stop the clock with an error on your part. 6 points, a minute 8. Plenty of time for Brownstown to get back and get this game tied up. Cameron will go all the way to basket or kick it out to 4-3.
Shot is short. Rebound tipped out. Anthony Moore gets it. Wrapped up there. Clint Parker and Jared Stahl. Personal foul will be against Brownstown Central with 1 minute to play. And Jimtown a 6-point lead. Jackson County REMC congratulates Brownstown Central in their quest to win the 2A championship and takes pride in providing safe, clean, and reliable electric service to its members. Jackson County REMC, your Touchstone Cooperative.
Okay, Chris, the good news is for Jimtown, Moore got fouled. The bad news is, well, he hits it. He's a 25% shooter, I think, on the year. What a great free throw for him.
Anthony Moore, 3 points now for the junior. Makes him bold.
Boy, he looked like he had better form than 25% there. He looked perfect.
And then Anthony Moore fouling Clint Parker.
My question is, Anthony Moore, why? You got 58 seconds. You lead by 8 points. Why will you stop the clock and put a guy up there that shoots 89% on the year?
Well, Clint Parker at the line. You're right, Dave. 89%, but he is 0-3 this afternoon. He missed a 1-1 in the first half. Missed a two-shot foul in the third quarter. Now he's at the free throw line. 58 and 14 seconds to play, and Parker makes it. 5 points now for Clint Parker. And four new players in for Brownstown with 58 and 14 seconds to play.
That's a little confusing to me, but I suspect Coach Benner has told him foul. And that way his starters still are in the ballgame, so I'm sure he's told him whoever catches the ball, foul and stop the clock.
Absolutely. Travis Maupin is in. Mason Watson in. Parker's free throw is good. 6 points. He has his four starters now standing by him waiting. And with 58 and 4:10 seconds to play, it's an 8-point lead.
If I'm Jimtown, I try to get it to my best free throw to shoot. They're going to throw it away again. No, they didn't.
Derrick DeShone lays it in.
That's the trouble, maybe, with that substitution, because your subs are not used to that run out.
Here's Lambrin right to the basket, lays it in, and David Venter gets a timeout. Chandler Lambrin lays it in with 49 and 8-10 seconds to play. And we'll have a full timeout, and we'll send it to a break. 58-52, Jimtown, a 6-point lead on the Methodist Sports Medicine Center scoreboard.
Kyle Johnson, 21 points for Jimtown, and Mom Kim is here. How you doing, Mom?
I'm doing fine. I'm a little nervous. It's been like the last minute and 12 seconds been the longest, I think, of my life. But hopefully they'll come through and make their free throws, and we'll bring home the blue.
All right, back to you guys.
All right, thanks, Craig. A nervous mom watching her son play.
Clearly saw the strategy there. Tyler Leighton came off three screens and kept moving, got the ball in his hands. He's an 83% free throw shooter. He was not going to give it up. He was going to let him run 10 seconds off the clock, or they had to foul him. So they did foul, put a good free throw shooter at the line for Jimtown.
He is 6 of 6 at the free throw line, including 4 of 4 here in the fourth quarter. He had 11 of his 15 points in the fourth quarter last week to win the semi-state against Garrett, and he has done much of the same here in the second half. Today, he has 13 of his 17 points here in the second half. And they have done this again without Chris Trobaugh.
Being an old coach who puts a lot of emphasis on defense, I really want to give credit to Anthony Moore from Jimtown. He's done the major job on Clint Parker this afternoon.
Jared Stahl missed it. Marty Young, the rebound, blocked by Kyle Johnson. Lambrin will put up a shot and draw the foul, a three-shot foul, as Lambrin was trying to launch it from the corner, and Derrick DeShone is called for the foul.
And look at Dad DeShone. He's pointing at his head. He said, son, you're making me look bad here. You inherited some of this. Now, let's don't, you know, you don't stop the clock and give a guy three free throws with 36.6. At least if the ball goes in, you can, the clock's still your friend, is still running.
Free throws now for Chandler Lambrin.
This really is going to open the door for to have Brownstown a chance. They'll get this down to a two-possession game with Lambrin at the free throw line.
Lambrin has scored all of his points here in the second half. He is 8 of 9 at the free throw line. He missed his first this afternoon. Now he's made 8 straight. He has 17 points. Made them all. The hat trick for Chandler Lambrin. 36 seconds to play, a 5-point Jimtown lead. And now a jump ball. Tyler Leighton did not want to give the ball up.
Brownstown basketball on the possession arrow.
And now the starters come back in. The guys come in, do their job on defense, force a turnover. And now with 31 and 6:10 seconds to play, Jimtown, a 5-point lead.
Going to the hoop.
Lambrin, a three. Didn't hit anything, and now DeShone the rebound.
Not much time, but that was a tough shot.
We'll walk the other way with 26 and 5:10 seconds to play. This has been a long fourth quarter. You heard Kyle Johnson's mom talk about it. This has been a long time. And if you are one of those fans, either from Brownstown or Jimtown, it has been a long fourth quarter.
I give Coach Venter credit. Venter, Dave, he went to the strategy of substituting in mass there to draw, to get fouls called. It's worked. They got it down to where his team had a two-possession game. Now time's really running out on him.
Clint Parker throws up a shot, misses. His brother gets it, Eric, and lays it in. Eric Parker with his first field goal. But time may be running out on Brownstown Central with 19 seconds to play. 19 seconds to play. Jimtown that far away from winning a 2A title on the LaCie IHSAA television network. Chris Cristinari and Dave Nicholson along with Craig Wallen. Jimmies have the ball, leading by five. Importantly, they also have the possession arrow. And as they look to inbound the ball, they just want to get the ball in, and they're going to look long. Tyler Leighton can't get it. They threw it too deep. And Brownstown Central now has a shot.
They threw it too deep. Leighton did a very intelligent thing there. He did manage to touch the ball.
Right.
Had he not done that, Brownstown would have had the ball under their own basket. At least Brownstown has to use some of the clock to advance full court.
And a lot of the court now, 94 feet they have to go. And the officials now conversing, you see. And the one official says, yes, it was tipped.
It was touched. Leighton clearly touched the basketball.
5-point game. Brownstown Central inbounds.
Clambering coast to coast. He'll either shoot it or take it to the hole.
Parker catches three, top of the key. It's in and out, no good. Rebound on the floor. Loose ball, jump ball. Arrow belongs to Jimtown.
9.3 seconds, and it pretty much closes it out for the Brownstown Braves. And one thing you need to say about Brownstown, they're 27-1 coming into the day. Marvelous year. This is going to hurt like crazy, as it always does. But every team except four teams in the state of Indiana are going to lose their last game. Coach Benner, the community and the county, everybody's going to be really proud of what this team established for Brownstown.
And the State Bank of Medora is very proud of the Brownstown basketball team. Stop by or call the friendly folks at State Bank of Medora, a small bank with a desire to grow. Member FDIC, located at East Main Street in Medora. Cristinari and Dave Nicholson, Craig Wallen, about halfway through our busy day here at Conseco Fieldhouse. Coming up tonight on many of these same stations, the 3A and 4A battles. It will be Belmont and Evansville Modern Day, 6:30 tonight, Indianapolis time. That will be for the 3A title. And then a rematch in Class 4A. They played a barn burner in the Hall of Fame Classic earlier this year in Newcastle. Exactly 3 months ago, Lawrence North beat Columbia City by one. And they'll play for the state 4A championship tonight. Should be a good one.
You're exactly right. I get it into Leighton's hand or Johnson's hand. 83 and 80% free throw shooters. I just wrap it up, make them foul me.
And they still have the possession arrow, and all they have to do is
there's
get it
Leighton
in, and Leighton has the ball, and he is fouled. Jimtown last week hit 13 of 17 at the free throw line in the second half to beat Garrett in the Warsaw semi-state. 25 of 29 at the free throw line, Dave, here in this ball game, and they have done an outstanding job of shooting free throws when they needed to.
Well, Chris, I don't think either team can feel badly about leaving thing on the floor. They left it all out there and used it up this afternoon.
Leighton misses. 25 of 30 at the line. They were 7 of 10 in the first half, so they've missed just two free throws here in the second half. Make it three. And the second is good by Leighton.
Not enough time.
To play. Two possession game. Lambrink, three, no good. Parker missed it. Rebound at the buzzer. It counts. But the Jimtown Jimmies have won the Class 2A state title. What a weekend for Randy DeShone. He shares it with two of his sons. His wife Tracy is expecting a child, and the Jimtown Jimmies are the Class 2A state titleists as they have beaten Brownstown Central 63-59. There you see a hug from Derrick DeShone and his father Randy DeShone. They thought about it as young kids, spending a lot of time on car trips with their father, and now Jimtown is the state titleist. Jimtown has won the 2A title, 63-59 over Brownstown Central. You saw it right here on the Lassie IHSAA television network. Dave Nicholson back courtside here at Conseco Fieldhouse, where the Jimtown Jimmies are the 2A state champion. They beat Brownstown Central, and they took the lead for good on this play. Derrick DeShone and Kyle Johnson, junior to senior. Tie game at 45, the fifth tie of the fourth quarter. And this is our Reeves Buick Pontiac play of the game, Dave.
There it is, a touchdown pass over the top to Kyle Johnson, who played a great game. definitely the play of the game. As you said, they never were headed after that basket.
There you take a look at the very happy Jimtown Jimmies, who win their first state title. Very well known for football, but now basketball is king up in Jimtown as they win the state championship. They scored 31 points in the fourth quarter. They had to play Brownstown's game. For the first three quarters, it was Jimtown's game, played at the pace that they wanted to play. But Jimtown's 31 points is a new record for points in a quarter in Class 2A. Batesville scored 28 in the fourth quarter against Fort Wayne Harding back in 2001. And they proved that they played their pace, Dave, and then they played Brownstown's pace in the fourth quarter.
Well, they had to, but 13 of those points in the fourth quarter came at the foul line. Brownstown was trailing, had the foul, and they just announced the Trester Award winner. I believe that's going to go to Kyle Johnson as well. Not only is he an outstanding basketball player, but obviously he's a good citizen and an outstanding student.
He is class president, student council. We talked to Randy DeShone earlier in the week, and he said Kyle Johnson is everything you would want on and off the floor. And here he is, the coach of the 2A state champ, standing by with Craig Wallen, Randy DeShone.
All right, thank you, guys. Randy DeShone, congratulations. It's been a long time for Elkhart County, but you did it.
It still hasn't hit me. I'm just so proud of these kids. Kyle Johnson just won the Mental Attitude Award. I can't think of a kid after what he's been through the last 2 years with his knee and how much he loves basketball. What a great kid he is. There's nobody that deserves that honor more. And it's just, these kids that work so hard, they deserve this. And Brownstown, what a great team.
Absolutely. Let's get a bite here from your son, Derek. Talk about injury. Derek, you're very familiar with injuries, but you battled through it just like Kyle did, just like everybody else did, Polston and the whole team. Congratulations.
Thank you. This is awesome. We've all battled through injuries the whole team this year, and we've always found a way to step up. And again, today we had Brian gave us some great minutes with Chris Trobaugh with food poisoning. Anthony Moore stepped up, and Jeremy Blumen came in, and everyone played as a team and played well.
Right, congratulations, Tyler Leighton. Congratulations to you.
This is for Chris and all Elkhart right here in this championship.
And Brian over here, another of the sons of Coach Randy DeShone. And Brian, what's it like to be an underclassman, to be in a game like this?
Oh, this is great. This has been one of the best things in my life I've ever done. I hope we can get back here later.
What did you feel like today when you heard that Chris Trobaugh was sick and wouldn't play and you'd have to get more minutes?
I was really surprised, and I knew we were going to have to step up and fill his place.
You did a great job.
Thank you.
All right. Back to you guys.
All right. Thank you very much, Craig. A very happy Jimtown bunch led by head coach Randy DeShone. A state championship for the Jimtown Jimmies. 21 points for Kyle Johnson to lead three double-figure scorers. Jimtown is the 2A state champ.
We are here. Jimtown has just won the 2A state championship. Kyle Johnson, the leading scorer, the heart and soul of this team, the Trester Award winner. Kyle, does it get any better than this, buddy?
No, it really doesn't. This is amazing.
All the injuries this team has faced, and in particular the injury last year, how disheartening was that? But what about the feeling you have right now in spite of it all?
This definitely makes up for that, I think. Never quit, you know, even in the hard times, I never quit. And having Trobaugh out today just gave us, I think, that little extra, you know, we're going to win one for Trobaugh, you know.
All right, Kyle, congratulations.
Thank you, sir.
Kyle Johnson, and we talked to Mom. Mom, get in here, and Dad, Gene. I know you two are very, very proud of your boy, but this Trester Award, I think, caps it off.
Well, it's just overwhelming at this point. I mean, for the kids just to be here, then to win the whole thing, and then for him to win the Trester, it's overwhelming. But, I mean, I won't come down for a week. I know that right now.
Mom had some nervous moments at the end. You were biting your nails, too, weren't you?
Well, I can't sit down. I have to walk up and down that tunnel back there and do what I got to do, get a drink, move around a little bit, make sure we win the game. And it worked again.
All right. Congratulations to you, Gene.
Thank you.
And Kim, congratulations again.
Thank you.
How proud can a mother be, huh?
Oh, I am so proud. I'm proud of the whole team. I'm proud of the community. And with Kyle's class, his basketball team had been close since like fourth grade. And without all of them together, I don't think this would have been possible.
You even had a question in your mind this season, whether or not Kyle would be able to continue to play. He had another reoccurrence of that knee problem, but he battled through it.
Yes, he did. We were about four games in the season. It was after the Northwood game. He had gotten bumped. And he knew something wasn't right. And as a matter of fact, I was in at Walmart, and he called and he says, "Mom, you have to get me to the doctor." Then we found out that he had to have knee surgery again for a rare cyst underneath his kneecap. So after that, it was like, oh no, how much more, you know, can he take? But I tell you, they all hung in, and his teammates supported him and the community, and it's been great.
Kim, thank you so much.
Thank you very much.
Kim and Gene Johnson, the proud parents of the Trester Award winner, Kyle Johnson, who is the leading scorer today, bringing back the medal and the first time ever in Elkhart County for a boys' state championship. Guys, back to you.
Thanks so much, Craig. Great story there for Kyle Johnson. 21 points today, 11 rebounds and 4 assists. Derrick DeShone also had a double-double today. He had 12 points, 11 rebounds, and 8 assists. And despite 20 turnovers today for Jimtown, they have enough to win this game. And they were able to do so, Dave Nicholson, by giving up the lead, because they had the lead for better than three quarters. Brownstown Central came back and took the lead at 41-40. In fact, had a two-point lead at 43-41, but Jimtown had enough to regain the lead and then hit free throws down the stretch.
They did, and I think you have to give them tremendous credit for that, Chris. You and I talked about the fact that Jimtown had played several close ball games. Brownstown Central really had not been in that many close ball games. That perhaps played a part into this, but give Jimtown the credit. They're the state champions, and they made the plays and made their free throws, particularly in the last minute and a half.
And what really hurt Brownstown today, they shoot only 32% from the field. They were 3 of 18 from three-point range. A team that attempts 19 threes per game, so they were right there, but they shoot 36% from three-point range. They make just three. And Clint Parker, 2 of 16 from the field. He had just 6 points. Marty Young had 19 points and 9 rebounds. Chandler Lambring had 18 points, and Lambring had all of those in the second half. 19 points for Tyler Leighton for Jimtown, and there you see the presentation of the 2A state trophy. There on your left is Kyle Johnson, class president, very active at Jimtown High School. And the Jimmies are the state titleists. And let's head back courtside. And with Coach Benter, a very disappointed Coach Benter, here's Craig. Craig?
Well, you're right, Chris. Disappointment, I'm sure, but it's a little bittersweet as well. It's been a great run for you, Coach.
Well, we've had a great season. You know, we came out today, and our kids played extremely hard. We just didn't play very smart in the first half in the offensive end. We took some bad shots and turned the ball over a little bit too much. But you know, our kids, just a great effort in the second half to get back in the game against a real quality Jimtown team. And I think, you know, we just missed some free throws and, you know, missed some shots late in the game, and Jimtown made some big plays.
No one would have thought you would have been here, but you were here, and you're going to miss four seniors. We congratulate them as they go out.
Oh, you know, you can't talk about how much they mean to our program. And, you know, we're really going to miss them. And, you know, this is something they're going to remember the rest of their lives.
Coach, thank you again.
Thank you.
Head coach Dave Benter. Guys, back to you.
All right. David Benter, an alum of Brownstown Central, disappointed in the four-point loss to Jimtown. The Jimmies, the 2A state champs. Jimtown Jimmies are the Class 2A state champions in 2004, their first basketball state title. They'll head back to Elkhart County victorious. They join Waldron, who earlier today won the Class A state championship. We have two more games tonight. Look forward to bringing you the 3A and 4A state title games. And it has been an enjoyable morning and afternoon here in Indianapolis at Conseco Fieldhouse. There's your two finals. Waldron won the 1A final. Jimtown is the 2A champion. For Dave Nicholson and Craig Wallen, our entire broadcast team, we'll see you tonight live from Conseco Fieldhouse.